Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, and guys, I'm back. If you haven't seen, I just posted another video right before this going over what you guys have to do before Madden 20. If you haven't seen that video, go watch that first, and then come back over here. Now, for this video, guys, I'm going to be going over the top rookie premier players to be taking, ranking them out of 10, going in the order that I think is the best. Obviously, things can change. I will go over all that in a second. But before I get into the video, guys, if you are new, if you are current, if you are old, make sure to drop a like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. Now, as per usual, guys, I will be giving away coins every video. So I'll be doing a 50k giveaway in this video. All you got to do is like the video and comment down below 50k. If we get 150 likes, I will be giving it away. You guys know the drill. If you're old, if you're current, and if you're new, now you do. So hopefully, you know, that can help you guys. It's kind of expensive to do right now, get these rookie premieres. So comment down below 50k. If we get 150 likes, I will be picking a commenter that could help you towards this, especially for you guys that want no money spent, don't have a lot of coins right now. But anyways, guys, let's get into this video. So if you go over to rookie premieres, there's 10 options. I went over in the last video how to get the tokens, the best way to get the tokens, the cheapest way at the moment. I went over the conversions of how they go. So now it's just time to rank them. So first things first, Kyler Murray obviously is the top one on my list by far. It's not even a debate. First off, having a Kyler Murray to start next year is already a plus as it is. And to make it even better, we both know Kyler Murray is going to be getting a ton of cards. Obviously, EA is up the ass of every new rookie that comes out. Big rookies. So like Saquon Barkley, week one, he hit an 88 overall. Who's to know that Kyler Murray might not get the same thing? An 88 overall. Remember the rookie thing with Saquon Barkley? Where literally the first week we had an 88 Saquon. That was huge to have Madden. So I'm going to be using my 10 tokens right here. Now, how I got these 10 tokens? I did the Ryan Shazier Mutt Master token. You go into the sets. You guys haven't watched the last video I showed you guys there, but pretty much you go into rookie premier sets. It's going to be all the way at the bottom. You're going to exchange it in your Mutt Master token. If you haven't done it yet, I recommend doing it, because right now rookie premieres cost 1.2 million per if you have no cards at all. So I'd highly recommend you guys go and you guys go finish Ryan Shazier. You're probably close at this point. If you've been playing Madden all year, you're probably pretty close if you haven't finished it already. So I have the Kyler Murray already. I have a 99 Kyler Murray. I might actually want to try that in a game, but that is huge. I now have a Kyler Murray for next year. I cannot wait. Think about it. The first week of Madden, having a mobile quarterback. He's only going to be like a 70 overall, I'm pretty sure. 78 or something like that. But that's still very useful for the first week. And if they do a rookie showcase like they did for Saquon, he will have like an 88 to 90 overall the second week of Madden. So that's huge. I am not complaining about that at all. So obviously that's first. Now, the reason I'm going to go over, I'm going to use football reasons for why he is first. First off, you obviously want the player with the clearest path to playing right away, because you want to have a card you can use all year. So some of these guys aren't exactly open to a player right away. If you know anything about football, you play fantasy football, you understand how opportunity is what matters most in football right now. For at least for getting a good player, because if they have the opportunity in their game, they can get team of the weeks. They can get, you know, they can be rookie of the year. You know, there's a lot of things. So let's go through this. So first off, Josh Jacobs. He's a running back. Running backs typically, unless you're like highly touted out of college, like you're like the top guy like a Saquon, usually don't get the touches right away. So there's a small chance that Josh Jacobs might not play week one, or he might be in a committee to start the year because they love doing that, putting him in a committee. The Raiders are a very run it first kind of team though, so that should be useful with Antonio Brown there. So Josh Jacobs is definitely up there, but I'm going to go through who I feel is second after Kyler Murray. So what I like to typically do here, I like the guys who have the most usage. So at cornerback, DeAndre Baker, I wouldn't put nearly in the top four, only because cornerback's a little harder. You know, you can go the whole season with just play really good defense. You might not have a lot of interceptions. You might not have a lot of big plays. You might just play good defense. So you might not get a team of the week, because just playing good defense doesn't get you team of the week. It's interceptions, pick sixes. The Giants might not have the best defense. So, you know, typically if you're the one cornerback on a pretty bad defense, you're going to struggle because everything else is going to be open for other people. So DeAndre Baker would not be my top one either. Obviously, safety is also not the easiest thing to do. So I would go with the gimmies, right? So first off, Chris Lindstrom and Nick Bosa. I feel like these are going to be easily two guys that I put for number two. Now, if I had to choose, Chris Lindstrom's on the Falcons. Very good run team. If you guys remember, Quentin Nelson got a pretty good year of cards. Team of the year, you know, being a lineman. But what I would go second is Nick Bosa. So Nick Bosa is going to be number two. He's going to start the gate for the Niners on a pretty juiced defense right now. Pretty young defense. Should be up and coming. Nick Bosa could easily have a few weeks of three sacks, multiple tackles for losses, maybe some strip fumbles, as long as he stays healthy. So Nick Bosa is going to be the guy that I go number two. I went last year in this exact order. I went Saquon, and then I went, what's that guy's name? Saquon and Bradley Chubb paid off well for me, had a nice end for a majority of the year, and a pretty good running back from almost the whole year. So definitely worth it. And obviously in the beginning of Madden, I also look at it, I want an end. I need some pass rushing, especially next year where it looks like pass rushing is going to be much improved. Going to need an end. Going to definitely want a quarterback. So I'm going to be going Kyler Murray and then Nick Bosa. Now, number three. I'm going to have to go, for me personally, Chris Lindstrom. He should be starting for the Falcons. He was a top guard that was picked in the draft. So hopefully he gets a quick path to playing. And he won't get a card right away. He's not going to get Team of the Week. But he will probably get a ghost of Madden future by that. And that means that I will have a top guard. If you guys know how Madden works, a 93 overall guard, mid-90 guard at the time of Christmas is a top guard in the game at the time. So I will be going with him. I do expect him to get consistent upgrades, like not early right away. So right away, he's just going to be like probably 78 to 80 overall guard. And I'm happy with that because I don't like buying linemen at the beginning of the year anyways. So that'll be a nice guard to have. Now going for number three. I'm going to go with Josh Jacobs. Because he has the highest upside of most of these players on this list. Because a running back on the Raiders, I'm pretty sure he can catch and run. He's kind of like a dual threat. Pretty sure. Don't kill me if I'm wrong on that. But I'm hoping so that I remember correctly on that one. Now, a running back's nice to have. If you remember, there's a lot of running backs are all the same. So having a free one's kind of nice. You don't have to go buy an expensive running back. Not to mention, he will be a 78 overall, I'm pretty sure, come week. Oh, it tells you right there, 74 overall. That's not bad. 74 overall is not bad for the first week, especially if you know money spent. And they will be upgrades. So Josh Jacobs, he has a geese in line for plenty of Team of the Week considerations. Plenty. As a running back, you know, just one big week, 200 yards, two touchdowns. And the Raiders always use it. We'll probably use him on the goal line. And we'll probably have him up there. Probably give him a good amount of volume at some point in the season. So when that happens, he's easily up there for Team of the Week. And that could easily be a 90 overall, 88 overall pretty early on. So that's why I'll be going with Josh Jacobs there. Now for the next one, which I believe we're at number five. I'm going to be going Quinnen Williams. I know I should have probably done him earlier, but he's a defensive tackle. So the position itself isn't as liked as many others when it comes to people who play Madden. Not many people even use the defensive tackles. Now they're changing overalls. Okay. So Kyler Murray's starting lower. Quinnen Williams is going to be a 77 and Nick Bosa will be a 77. Okay, that's pretty good though. So the linemen will be useful right away. So Quinnen Williams, he's on the Jets D-line. The Jets have a pretty good defense. Pretty up-and-coming defense. They have a top D-line, obviously. They always have good D-linemen. So for that reason alone, Quinnen Williams at defensive tackle. It's a nice position to have locked up. I like having defensive tackle locked up. I do not like having to worry about it and put coins into it. He should have a good year. He's one of the top picks, so obviously, you know, he's pretty good. And as a defensive lineman, few run stuffs. Could easily get a defensive team of the week. And if he doesn't, he could easily be one of the pieces for defensive team of the week. He would probably get a ghost of future to top picks usually do. So you can probably account for this guy being a 93 by Christmas. So that's always a plus. Now at number six, the tough one, I will probably be going, as much as I like DeAndre Baker, I mean, I can't trust it. I know as a cornerback, I know as from a football standpoint, when your whole secondary isn't doing too good, you're just picked apart. The cornerback can only do so many things. When you're in a top defense, that's when you show up, but it's going to be hard. He could be the one lone bright spot, but I can't bank on that, especially with how the Giants typically are. I will be probably going with Darnell Savage next. Free safety. If you guys remember having that. Ooh. I'm going to blank. Derwin James. Having Derwin James was the top safety last year. He could hit. He was tall. And he was fast. He could catch. It was kind of nice having that most of the year. I could always use a free safety. Again, I don't like buying safeties. I don't know why. I feel like they're always overpriced, always like an Earl Thomas kind of guy, and they're, you know, those kind of cards are always so overpriced. Don't enjoy buying them. And a lot of the packages I use, they play in weird spots, they play in the box anyway, so it's not for me, but again, these are my rankings. Obviously, it sways. Remember, football changes. Football's always changing. Week one, Kyler Murray can get hurt. Hopefully, he doesn't, but, you know, like, Josh Jacobs could end up not having a role till week seven. Football's weird like that. Pre-season injury, so I'm just going off of what I believe will work best for me. Not too much to say about Darnell Savage. I just like having a safety. Now going to, I believe we're at number seven, right? We did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we're at number seven. So number seven, that's a tough one. I'll probably go in Devin Bush. So typically, if history shows, the Steelers always have a good scheme for their linebackers. I don't know what it is. Their linebackers always ball. Devin Bush is fast. He can catch. He can hit. He can stuff the run. I mean, he's kind of a a prototype, can do it all kind of linebacker. So for that reason, Devin Bush should be in a good position to have easy weeks. If you guys remember TJ Watt last year, TJ Watt had tons of team of the weeks. TJ Watt was always being upgraded. So obviously it wasn't the rookie premiere. The point being is Shazier, TJ Watt, Bud Dupree, those cards are Steelers linebackers always get most feared. They always get something. So for that reason, Devin Bush could easily fit that role of a guy who could have as a user linebacker. I'm pretty sure he's not too small. He's fast, he can catch, he can do it all. So for that reason, Devin Bush is definitely a worthwhile card to have. Now, we're dragging this video a little bit, so I'm going to try to speed it up. We're down to 8, 9, and 10. So what is left is DeAndre Baker and Marquise Brown, Josh Jacobs. See, Marquise Brown, I want to like, but the issue with Marquise Brown is that he's on the Ravens. They're not a pass-first team, they're run-first. So for that reason, if you guys know the Ravens, they typically struggle to consistently have a wide receiver one or two that they could use that have the stats of a wide receiver one or two, because they spread it around. They don't really lock onto one guy. I mean, if he's that good, maybe they could. But unless Lamar Jackson takes a massive uptick in passing this year and really improves his accuracy, I can't see Marquise Brown being a top wide receiver in the league. He might have the talents too, but for that reason, I'm going to go with him. Not yet. I'm probably going in this position. I will be going probably TJ Hockenson. Tight end is typically a hit or miss position, right? But if he hits, he'll probably get a ghost of the future. If he hits, he could be really good. He's tall. He's one of the top tight ends in the league in the draft. But tight end is very, very iffy. Tight end players, they typically don't do well year one. Tight ends are more of a long-term project, maybe like year two or three. But he could be a good run blocker and a decent catcher, and he's tall. So for all those reasons, I'm going to put him up there over at least Mark. He looks like he has a better path with Matthew Stafford at quarterback and letting Golden Tate being gone to actually scoring and doing stuff on that offense. They're going to need a score. Now for 9, I'm going to be going DeAndre Baker for the Giants. Just being a cornerback, I mean, if he just has 1 week with like 2 deflections and a pick or maybe pick 6, he could have a team of the week, easily have an 87 overall card pretty early, 84, 85. So for that reason, I'll be going Baker, and it's a cornerback. Now, got to speed this up, sorry guys. And then for the last one, Marquise Brown. Wide receiver is just so iffy. Wide receiver and tight end for the first year is so iffy. Since the 2014 draft, not many wide receivers like Odell, Mike Evans, Brandon Cooks, Sammy Watkins, like since that draft, not many first-round wide receivers have really just broken out on the spot, especially in the position he's in on the Ravens. Like I said, with Lamar Jackson, I can't see it happening altogether in year one, but it could happen. So for that reason, obviously, he's up there, but he's the last one for me. Be the last guy I focus on. That's about it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I know this video dragged a little bit, but hopefully it helps you guys out, gives you some insight on my thoughts on this. So if you guys enjoyed, make sure to drop a like, comment 50K down below. If we hit 150 likes, I will be giving away 50K, help you guys complete some of these. And then also, if you guys are new, drop a sub. We're going hard probably daily from here on out, trying to make the most of this final month, get some momentum going back to Madden 20. And obviously, Madden 20, we're going off. I'm going to be doing about 3 to 4 videos a day, at least for August and the end of July. And then hopefully by Christmas, I mean, I have a goal. I'm hoping like 20K subs by Christmas, 20 to 30K subs. If we can do that, I'll be so happy. Guys, that is the goal. Let's make it happen. I have 2,136 of you guys here currently. Hope you guys, some of you guys come back from Madden 20 and just help me out a little bit. You know, dropping a like really helps. It always does. Dropping a like and commenting, showing some interaction, watching my video helps. So I hope you guys can help me make this happen for Madden 20. I'm out. See you guys in the next video.